Hello, hello to the students that we have joining our webinar this evening. We will be getting started very shortly. Welcome, welcome to the Marin Virtual College Fair. Students, just a couple things to let you know. If at any point in time you have a question throughout the presentation, it doesn't have to be exactly when that presenter is presenting, but throughout the time, if you'd like to ask a question, use that Q&A button that's at the bottom. It can be institution specific, or it could be a question maybe that all of our presenters might want to answer for you. Your camera and microphone are off, so the only way to communicate is through that Q&A box. And just as a reminder, there are more sessions coming up for this virtual college fair. So check out the schedule and sign up for additional presentations. And this recording will be available later on that same website where you registered for this session. So without further ado, I am going to pass it off to our representative from Catholic University.
Thank you very much for having us, and thank you everyone for joining us tonight. We appreciate you taking the time to learn a little bit more about universities on the East Coast. My name is Sarah Cronin. I'm Associate Dean of Admission at Catholic University, and I'm going to share my screen. And let me just give me one second, screen up here. Sorry about that. And so I'd like to share a little about Catholic University in the time I have. We are a national research university located in Washington, DC. We are the National University of the Catholic Church. We are actually the second oldest graduate research university in the country. And with that, we have over 30 different research centers on campus for both our undergraduate and our graduate students. We're about 6,000 students on campus, 3,300 undergraduate and 2,600 graduate students. About 80% of our students do identify as Catholic. About 30% of our students do identify as coming from an ethnically diverse community. We have students from over 40 different countries on campus. And although we are very much, yes, a Catholic university, we're also a university that is acceptable and welcoming to all different faiths and all different communities. So we are located in Washington, DC. We are not right downtown, we're on the east side of the city. And because of that, we're much more a suburban looking campus than we are an urban campus. Of all the universities in DC, we are the largest campus. It's 170 acres. So it's very much a residential self-contained community. We do guarantee housing for 3 years. We require housing for 3 years, and many of our seniors do live on campus. And some of our seniors also move off campus in our neighborhood, our Brooklyn neighborhood, which in apartments and housing around the university as well. We are excited to also be building in the works right now, we're building a new dining hall, and we anticipate that that will be completed in about a year or so, and a new residence hall and a new nursing building in the works as well. In this picture you can see here, if you look up the Basilica, this is the largest Catholic church in Washington, DC. It's not officially part of our campus, but it's right next door. We get to use it for graduation and convocation. Our choirs, our orchestras, numerous events take place in it. Amazing acoustics and a wonderful, beautiful church for us to use throughout the school year. We certainly believe our location provides amazing opportunities for our students. Certainly many students think DC and they think government, and we have multiple government federal type of internships for our students, but there's so much more going on in DC in terms of history and culture and art and music, and certainly professional sports teams, the World Series champs, the Nats, the great hockey team, obviously, and men's and women's basketball team, and our football team needs a little bit of work. But we're excited that our students have numerous opportunities to really engage in the city. So our campus is very active, involved in numerous activities and things, but our students are also willing and able and ready to take advantage of DC. Of the many universities in DC, only two have their own metro stops, and we are one of them. So we like to talk about that because it gives our students access, it provides them opportunities to head downtown to do an internship with the Senate Majority Whip at the Capitol building, to do an internship with the White House Press Corps at the White House, to do an internship at the National Treasury, at the Treasury Department down near the Smithsonian. So there are many opportunities for our students to actively engage in DC and internships, to take advantage of DC and the culture and the art and the history. So many opportunities for our students. And because we have that metro access, our students are really busy around DC and a variety of different things. As a research university, we believe that our students, our undergraduates, have multiple opportunities for research, for internships, but we also have a liberal arts foundation as well. And so we have a core curriculum that all of our students have to take. We offer over 70 different undergraduate majors, 9 different schools and colleges. But we also have so many students who start undecided, and that's perfectly okay. We have a wonderful academic and career advising office. We've actually combined academic advising and career services in one place, and it's there, our Center for Academic and Career Success. And so every student works with a mentor in that CACS office to work with students as they're deciding on particular majors or exploring internship opportunities or career advising or developing their resume, those types of things. Certainly, as a smaller university, we very much believe in a personal approach to education, very much discussion-based classes. Our average class size is 19. Our student-faculty ratio is 7 to 1. So our students are very active, engaged with faculty, and faculty getting to know their students, and students getting to know our faculty. As I mentioned, we have over 75 different undergraduate majors, 9 different schools and colleges focused on undergraduate, 12 schools overall at the university. And this is our list of undergraduate schools that you can see here. Our School of Arts and Sciences is the largest school at the university. And certainly politics is our most popular major. Yes, we're in Washington, DC, but we offer a variety of majors. International business is very popular. Psychological and brain science, which is a BS and focuses in neuroscience, is a very popular major. Nursing certainly is very popular. Biomedical engineering is a growing and popular major within our School of Engineering. And our students are interning at NASA. Our students are interning at the White House. Our students are interning at the Capitol building. So a variety of opportunities, no matter your major, in many different ways, our students are engaged throughout DC and through these different majors. As I mentioned, we have our liberal arts and our core that all students are required to take. So we do have this first year experience that all of our students are engaged in. It's covers both English and philosophy and theology, a class of no more than 18 students. Our faculty take advantage of DC and do first generation research at the Library of Congress or going to observe some artwork at the National Gallery. So many opportunities in DC, and our faculty certainly take advantage of DC through the classroom opportunities. We also have University Honors Program. It's not a separate application. We invite the top 10% of admitted students to join our Honors Program. Smaller classes, seminar style. Many of our classes are discussion-based, but our honors classes are all focused in discussion-based. And certainly many of our honors students are planning postgraduate work and undergraduate work after their undergraduate experience. Certainly study abroad is a big component of many of our students. Over 40% of our students do study abroad. We do have a flagship program in Rome, and many of our students take advantage of that opportunity. And certainly vibrant community activities and clubs and numerous programs through community service and our campus ministry, clubs and organizations on campus. So there's many ways our students are engaged on campus. We also are a Division III in terms of athletics, a landmark conference, and also numerous different club sports and intramural sports our students are engaged in. Finally, the application review, a little bit of information about our deadlines, early action, early decision. One is due November 1st, regular decision or ED2 is due January 15th. There's no application fee to apply to Catholic University. And brand new this year, we are not taking any SATs or ACTs. We have moved test blind. So we've been test optional the last 4 or 5 years. We believe and know that so many students are having a challenge and a hard time getting a test. So we are not reviewing any SATs or ACTs for admission consideration or for merit scholarships. So we have moved test blind in the admission process. So this is some information about our merit scholarships. Academic scholarships range from $17,000 to $30,000. A per scholarship
for legacy. Thanks so much. We do need to move on to the next presenter.
I will stop sharing. And any questions along the way, certainly please let me know. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We are going to head over to Salve Regina now, University. Thank you so much.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nick Albanese with Salve Regina University in Rhode Island. I'm a proud alumnus of Salve. I graduated back in 2012, and I'm actually based on the West Coast. So I live in Seattle, and I'm proud to travel down to Marin County every year. And we actually have a few students from your county on campus now. The Sisters of Mercy are the order of nuns who founded Salve, Regina, and they gave us our mission statement. And I always like to point out mission statements. I think they're a really good way to understand in just a short amount of words, kind of the vibe and the priorities of the college. And so our very first line is, as a community that welcomes people of all beliefs, which I really think speaks to our inclusivity. And our last line is, we work for a world that is harmonious, just, and merciful. We do that by, in many different ways, but particularly thinking about earth, immigration, nonviolence, racism, and women, and really asking our students, you know, what can you do to improve the world around you, particularly in those areas? We have just over 2,100 students, so we're a small university, and we have a little over 50 undergraduate majors, as well as lots of graduate programs. Some of our more popular majors are business, administration of justice, biology, chemistry. We, of course, have a very well-known direct entry nursing program where we guarantee the clinicals, so you will finish in 4 years. We also have some unique programs. We have a Bachelor of Arts in Dance, and we have a really cool program called Cultural and Historic Preservation, where students learn about the built environment, and they learn how to restore, advocate, protect, care for historic objects, buildings, and even entire neighborhoods. And it makes sense that we have a historic preservation major because we're located in one of the best kept historic districts in the United States. We're in the Mansion District of Newport, Rhode Island. So we are right on the ocean. We have 80 acres, 7 estates that we converted, mansions, barns, stables, carriage houses, turning those buildings into the residence halls and the classrooms, along with newer buildings over the year. It makes for a level 2 arboretum, the only one in the state, a very beautiful and inspiring place to go to college. But what I think is kind of the neatest thing about that is that we have this campus that's open and part of the neighborhood. So students feel very connected to the people around them on the island where we're located. We're only about an hour and a half from Boston, and there are direct flights from San Francisco to Boston, or we're about 25 minutes from our local airport if you wanted to do a layover. But when you go over the bridges onto our island, you really feel like you're in this quintessential New England town from the 1600s with the cobblestone streets and all these wharfs going onto the water. There's a big surf culture in town. So just some fun facts there. There's lots of things to do on campus. We have 19 varsity sports, Division III, very well known for sailing. We also have some ice hockey players from your area on campus. And we have club sports like rugby. We have over 70 student-led organizations. That's our multicultural student organization there at the top right. We have speakers who come from all over the world. The Pell Center for International Relations and Public Policy, which was founded by an act of Congress, brings these speakers from around the globe to the campus, and students can be inspired and listen to their presentations. We have lots of activities going on, and community service is actually a pretty big activity for our students. We get back over 15,000 hours a year with over 60 organizations right in our backyard on the island. In terms of admissions, most students have between a B+ and an A- GPA. We take a weighted GPA, so if your school does not provide one, then we will weigh it up. We are completely test optional. We've been test optional for nearly a decade. That includes our direct entry nursing program this year. So we understand how to evaluate you without the scores and do a very holistic review. In addition to that, our test scores are, test optional policy means that our merit scholarships are not only tied to your grades, they're tied to our entire holistic review. Most students from California have pretty significant scholarships because it's a big priority for us to recruit more students from California. But our merit awards alone range from $12,000 to $25,000 off the cost of tuition. You're automatically evaluated for them. They're renewable every year. And then we have other scholarships and grants as well based on need. Our upcoming deadline is November 1, but we also have a deadline on January 5 and February 1. All these, except for early decision, are not binding. Nursing students do need to apply by November 1. And then finally, we have some events coming up. So I encourage you to go to salve.edu/visit. We have workshops, information sessions. We actually have in-person tours. So if you're planning on traveling to Rhode Island, we might be able to give you a tour. And we have an open house coming up on November 1, which is a really great way to learn about the university. Speaking about in-person tours, Salve Regina is essentially fully in person. We've done over 4,000 asymptomatic tests, and we've only had 4 positive cases. So if you're looking for a university where you can feel confident about going out of state, even during a pandemic, a place that's gonna be adapt and work with you as a student, check us out. We might be a good option for you. There's my contact information here. I hope to hear from you soon, but we'll turn it over to our next presenter. Thank you very much.
Excellent. Thank you so much. We're going to pass it over now to the University of Vermont.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and I work with the University of Vermont. I'm thrilled to be speaking to Marin County students. I used to live in Marin for about 6 years, so it's great to be connecting with students from the area, even if it's a virtual platform. I work in, and I'm based in Southern California, so just like Nick, I'm also, I work remotely. The University of Vermont is a public research university with about 10,000 students. In terms of academics, we have a lot of different programs, anywhere from business to engineering to education to the arts and sciences to environmental studies. So as you can see, we have a lot of different programs. And to organize the academics, we have 7 different colleges. Some unique programs at UVM include our animal sciences. For students that want to go into becoming a vet, we have a bachelor's, master's, and a PhD in food systems, so we take our food very seriously. And we're also very passionate about environmental studies. With that program, you can study environmental studies at 3 out of the 7 different colleges. In addition to all these different colleges, we also have a medical school and a hospital right on campus, which provides a lot of exposure for students interested in the health and natural sciences. UVM is the 5th oldest university in New England, but if you've been to campus or you browse through our website, you'll see that a lot of our buildings are actually pretty new. So we continue to invest in our students and our facilities. This past summer, we just opened our brand new STEM complex, which will be a great facility, not only for our engineering students, but all our students in general. We opened our brand new residence hall about 2 years ago, which is located right in Central Campus. And we're in the process of building a brand new athletic facility for our Division I sports. Being that we're a medium-sized institution, our students really like the fact that UVM is sort of the perfect size, large enough where you're able to find all the resources that you can find at a large research public institution, but your classes are actually pretty small. The average class is about 32 students, and the overall faculty to student ratio is 1 to 18. And lastly, our students really like that UVM offers urban and open spaces. We're located in the largest city in the state of Vermont, but we're surrounded with beautiful green mountains, and Lake Champlain is just down the street. As a Division I school, there's a lot of exciting things happening at UVM, athletics being one of them. We have about 18 varsity sports, but we also have club sports intramurals. We have over 200 clubs and organizations and a Greek system. About 8% of our students are involved in the Greek system. But at the end of the day, what really excites our students is academics. Every single student has an academic advisor who will guide you in making sure that you graduate in 4 years. And we also have quite a few accelerator programs for students that are wanting to get their bachelor's and master's within 5 years. We have about 40 different options for our accelerator programs. Over 70% of our students come from outside of Vermont. And so with such a big out-of-state population, our students build a strong sense of community by living on campus. Every single freshman lives in a learning community, which matches your interests, whether it be in the classroom or outside of the classroom or your living environment. So some of these learning communities include arts and creativity, sustainability and wellness environment, among others. We're located in the city of Burlington, which is a super fun college town. In addition to UVM, there's 2 other universities in the city of Burlington. So the entire city revolves around college students, which is really fun and exciting. We do have an airport. It's actually an international airport because it has flights into Canada. But you can also drive into Canada, as Montreal is only an hour and a half away. Montpelier, which is the capital, is about a 30-minute drive from campus. For students that are getting ready for the application process, at UVM, you can submit your application through the Common App or My Coalition. Whichever application works best for you will work best for us. For fall 2021, we are test optional, and I wanna emphasize the fact that we're test optional. So please don't put yourself in an unhealthy situation just to take your test. We have early action and regular decision. The deadline for early action is November 1st. So you have a few more days to complete your file. And we'll review those files. And by mid-December, all students who complete the early action decision deadline will be notified of their admissions decision. At that point, you also know which merit scholarship you'll be considered for. Our merit scholarships are based on your academics. So the stronger the GPA, the stronger the scholarship you get. These scholarships range from 8,000 to 20,000, and you'll be automatically considered with your admission application. And to conclude this presentation, I'm often asked to describe a typical UVM student, which is a little bit difficult to do just because we have over 10,000 students and our students come from all over the US. But typically our students are very engaged in their academics. They come to UVM because they wanna be able to conduct research as an undergraduate student. But they also come to UVM because they love the outdoors. As you can see in this picture, we have mountains and Lake Champlain just down from campus. And they're also environmentally conscious, whether that's something they want to study. Most of our students come to UVM because they want to use their academics to make a more sustainable world. So if that sparked any food for thought about some of the options that you're looking for college, check out UVM. Lastly, I'm also with two students, current UVM students in the webinar. So feel free to stop by and ask some questions to learn more about the student perspective. Thank you.
Excellent. We will now pass it off to our representative from Creighton University.
Good evening. My name is Ann Hardy, and I'm the Associate Director of Admissions for Creighton University. I am actually an alumna of the school. I study nursing. I'm a nurse practitioner, and I practiced for 20 years before moving into admissions. And I live in the Sacramento area. And if you choose to apply to Creighton, I'm the one that would read your application. I'm going to share a presentation with you. So Creighton is a Jesuit school, and we are located in Omaha, Nebraska. And there are 27 Jesuit universities in the country. And so we are part of that network. The Jesuits are the largest order of Catholic priests. You certainly do not have to be Catholic to attend Creighton or any one of the 27 Jesuit universities in the country. And our values are to be men and women for and with others. At Creighton, we are educating and forming leaders for a more just world. Another one of our values is cura personalis, care for the individual, and education of the whole person. We want to make sure our students are well-rounded. We offer 140 different academic programs at Creighton, and our student body, our undergraduate population is about 4,400 students, and our graduate population is another 4,400 students. We truly, like I said, are a liberal arts school, well-rounded education. Our student to faculty ratio is 11-1, and our average class size is 24 students. We get 80% of our students from out of state, which is great because we are not a commuter school and we're not a suitcase campus where people just live out of their suitcase and pack up and go home on the weekends. We have students from all 50 states and 50 different countries. Our undergraduate programs are the College of Arts and Sciences, the Hyder College of Business, and the College of Nursing, which is direct entry. Nursing is our only undergraduate major that students declare when they apply to Creighton. Our arts and science students declare a major at the end of sophomore year, and our business students at the beginning of junior year. We also have our own medical school, dental school, law school, physical therapy, occupational therapy, pharmacy, nurse practitioner, physician assistant, and a graduate school with 50 other programs that all give preference to our undergraduate students, which is a really big deal. So the acceptance rate from our undergrad into our medical school is about 50%, and that acceptance rate goes down to about 5 or 6% for students applying outside of Creighton undergrad. And then the med school, 50% is actually the lowest one. They keep going up after that, the other programs. So we're really proud that of our the preference that we give to our undergraduate students. We have developed an interprofessional approach to education, which means that it's very much a team approach, especially to healthcare, very much a team approach. Because if you work in healthcare, you're going to be working on a healthcare team. We're building a second healthcare campus in Phoenix, and when that is complete in 2021, we will be the largest Catholic healthcare education provider in the world. So we're very excited about that. Our students, well, Creighton was voted one of the top schools in the country for undergraduate research opportunities, and we want our students to come in freshman year and engage in research right away and actually get to do the work. Our Hyder College of Business students are well connected in the Omaha community, and all of our business professors have practical experience in their field. We have 6 chartered financial analysts on faculty at Creighton, which is more than any other business school in the world. And we offer 2 practicums on campus, the IJ Apple Store practicum, which is unique to our campus. So that's for business students. They actually get to run the Apple Store. And we also offer an investment practicum, an investment portfolio practicum, where students invest $6.5 million of our school's endowment. And we have 9 Bloomberg terminals set up live to the New York Stock Exchange on campus. Whoops. Omaha. So Omaha is a city of just shy of 1 million people. It kind of reminds me a lot of Sacramento, where it's a smaller downtown with lots of suburbs. And except for that, Omaha is much different in that it was voted the #1 city for paid internships. We actually have more internships than we have students to fill them. And Omaha is home to 4 Fortune 500 companies with another 50 or 60 with operations there. It's a fun place to live and there's a lot going on. We offer 250 clubs and organizations for our students, including sorority and fraternity life. Our students are actively engaged in service and campus ministry opportunities, neither one required, but because of who we are, we naturally attract students who want to be involved in service and justice and be involved in campus ministry opportunities. We are Division I, part of the Big East Conference, and on a typical year, we get over 18,000 fans at every home men's basketball game. We are also the host of the College World Series, and we have lots of club sports and intramural sports, and students get into all home games for free. You just show your ID. We offer many, many different study abroad programs, including our Global Scholars Program, which students spend 2 semesters away and 2 summers away. We are very proud of our student outcomes. And I'm going to go through the application process with you. So we are on the Common App or the Creighton application. It makes no difference to us which one you use. And we are test optional. We went test optional last year. So you do not need a test score for admissions consideration or merit scholarship consideration. We are also open to visitors right now. So if you did want to visit, we have students on campus and with, of course, all the precautions. So you would have to register online. And then I'm going to wrap it up because I think my time is almost up. So that is my contact information. Thank you.
Excellent. We will now pass it off to our presenter from Sacred Heart University.
All right, thanks, Kara. Good evening, everyone. My name is Sarah Koloski. I'm the Regional Director of Admissions for Sacred Heart University. I'm based in Denver, Colorado, so just an hour ahead of you guys. So if you have any questions down the line, feel free to contact me directly. So Sacred Heart is a mid-sized Catholic university. We are located in Fairfield, Connecticut. We're about 5,400 undergraduate students alongside 3,700 graduate population as well. We're sort of this hybrid of liberal arts meets career education. So while most of our students do come in undecided, we're looking very much at the exploratory side, letting students really define their experience, but then you also have the option for some direct entry and combined graduate programs as well. Love the 60 undergraduate programs that we do offer. 40 of them have an accelerated or combined graduate. Most of our, we see about 40% of our student body come back to a site-specific Sacred Heart grad program. Our top programs include direct entry nursing, anything in the health professions, including a doctorate of physical therapy, occupational therapy, athletic training, and then we move on to business, criminal justice, and psychology, kind of in our top 5 there. We are a Catholic university, but we are independent from the church. So we don't actually have religious requirements for our students. Very similar to Creighton's experience, you are looking to talk, have it with a dialogue. More students are going to be interested in community service. And with all the clubs and activities that we do have on campus, Habitat for Humanity is our largest student-run club. So we really want students to engage in the faith at their own discretion. It's something that really unites us as a community overall, and wanting to sort of dedicate that to others around us as well. We're in a very pivotal growth phase right now. As I mentioned, we sort of have these high accolades, particularly in the health professions and our health sciences. We are top in state, top five in New England for all of our programs, with an exceedingly score of 100% pass rate on all of our boards and NCLEX exams for our respective students. This year was actually the first time we had 100% first time pass rate for our FNP program as well. So students are coming out. We had reports from the Career and Professional Development Office that we've had a 99% job placement rate. And also, being located in the third most concentrated area of Fortune 500 companies, there are internships readily available in our backyard. For our nursing program, we actually are partnered with four different hospitals in the area. And we also have the opportunity for students to study abroad for a full semester on our Ireland campus, which has a hospital. So students are able to continue their clinicals and have this global experience. And oftentimes students are looking to have that minor in global health and see that impact there as well. We, in the last 7 years, have had 13 new buildings introduced to campus. So it's a completely different school than it's been even 5 years ago. We've added more dining options on campus. You can see our JP's Diner, which is one of three college campuses to have a traditional East Coast diner as a food option on campus. It's right in the middle of our athletics fields. It's a great place for students to come together, really emphasize that community, and have a open and welcome space to do that. We have our WSU Public Radio and Public Safety Center to further communications both on and off campus. We're adding new dormitories. The biggest project we've had recently is our acquisition of GE's former headquarters, which is now home to our College of Business and Technology. Particularly for my undecided engineers, or someone who's not looking for necessarily an impacted track in the engineering or technical sciences, this is a great place to look. We are looking to expand our engineering program. We already have a lot of unique majors such as game design, electrical engineering, information systems, computer engineering. So this is actually home to an 11,000 square foot makerspace, artificial intelligence labs, and game design labs that will be at your access at any time. We've also added an additional rec center, which is in the bottom middle corner there. So we wanted to allocate extra space for our Division I programs alongside our 35 club sports. So we're seeing students very active in that area. And finally, we did purchase a community theater in downtown Fairfield to further our growth in the performing arts. We're top 20 in the country for our performing arts program with a direct connection to Broadway. And there are over 28 performing arts groups that students can be involved in on campus. And finally, I just want to highlight what our admissions process looks like. It's pretty much the same as it's been in years past. We just added early action to this year. The only thing I encourage is if any of my nursing students are looking to apply, they must apply by the December 15th deadline to be considered. We are test optional for all of our programs, including direct entry nursing. As you can see, the ranges are listed here. So if you are at or above these ranges, I would encourage you to send them just to strengthen your overall application, and it could incentivize more scholarship. But we have also been test optional for about 15 years. So if you are not looking to send scores, it is okay. I do encourage you to get in touch with me for an interview or participate in any of our virtual events, or if you feel comfortable, we are open for visits as well on campus with limited capacity. So please don't hesitate to reach out, and I believe that's my time. Thanks so much.
All right, and on to our final presenter for this evening, the University of Maryland.
All right, thank you so much, Kara. Good evening, everyone. My name is Larry Kalangi, and I am the Regional Admissions Coordinator for University of Maryland based in Los Angeles. To get started, UMD is now ranked number 19th according to US News and World Reports. Last year, we were ranked number 22nd, so we take pride in our students, faculties, and staff members to make this great strive. Whether it's from our research, leadership labs, the rankings are based on more than 15 measures of academic quality, including graduation and retention rates. We're very proud of these distinctions and continue to foster excellence each and every year. We're also number 10th and number 16th best value for in-state students and out-of-state students, respectively by Kiplinger's Personal Finance. We have about 30,000 undergraduate students with over 800 student clubs and organizations. So there is really something for everyone. There are 12 academic colleges plus letters and sciences, which is an advising house for students that are undeclared or undecided. There are over 90 academic majors and programs. Students can also double and triple major or declare a major and minor in another subject. I encourage you to find your passion. College is the time to find who you are, engage and find your interests. Get out of your comfort zone. Our most popular majors among California students are computer science, business, government and politics, biological sciences, and engineering. Some of our majors are limited enrollment programs or LEPs. Because of their strong reputations, they are highly sought after majors and we must limit enrollment to maintain program quality. As a result, these programs have competitive requirements beyond the admission standards of the university. The environment and the setting of your studies is a leadership lab. University of Maryland is uniquely positioned right outside of Washington, D.C. Beltway. So all of our students can enjoy the abundance of cultural, professional, and recreational opportunities Washington, D.C. has to offer. Many of our students decided to intern or work for federal agencies, nonprofit organizations, cultural experiences, and the National Smithsonian Museum. We're about 10 miles from the White House, and we're also surrounded by three major international airports that makes traveling to from very easy. This year, University of Maryland are on the Common App and the Coalition App. This year, Maryland will be test optional. This means that test scores are not required to complete your application. Your application will still be reviewed holistically using the 26 admissions factors that are qualitative and quantitative and review. You will not be disadvantaged by not deciding to submit a test score. However, if you do plan to submit a test score, you must indicate that on your application. Once you submit that application, you will not be able to go back and change it. So think very carefully, have this conversation with your parents and your counselors as well. So think carefully, you will not be able to go back and change it. You will not be disadvantaged for not submitting a test score. At University of Maryland, we do require two letter of recommendations, one from your counselor and one from your teacher. A recommendation letter can speak to your resilience as a student, your ability to lead, and your work ethic in the classroom. Letters can also address any challenges or concern. At University of Maryland, we do require one essay, and it can be from Common App or Coalition App prompt, or you can choose to write anything you want. The purpose of the essay is for the admissions committee to learn more about you as a prospective student. We do not have an interview process, so your essay can set you apart from other applicants. We do require you to put an activity list or a resume. You can send us both. You can put that on the application and send us a separate resume as well. At UMD, we are an early action. Early action, which is non-binding. November 1st, it is our deadline. 90% of the admitted class is taken from this school. So I encourage you all to apply early action. Early actions also, it is also our honors, living and learning, as well as our merit scholarship deadline. And so it is very important to apply early actions. However, our regular decision deadline, which is January 20th. That concludes my presentations. Please follow us on all of our social media platforms at Apply Maryland on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook to check out what's happening at University of Maryland. Thank you for joining us today, and I will pass it back on to Kara.
Thank you so much to all of our presenters today and for our students for joining us. We do have about 6 minutes or so still remaining in the session. So students, if you do have any more questions, please feel free to use that Q&A button down at the bottom. But just to utilize that little bit of time that we have remaining, presenters, if we could go back in that order that we presented in from the start, maybe about 30 to 40 seconds, anything that last thing you wanted to share, or maybe some kind of campus tradition or fun story for our students here before we end. So I'll start with Catholic University.
Fun traditions. We have our Cardinal Palooza each fall, and it's just a way that every single student and faculty member, administrator all come out and do all sorts of fun fairs and programs and activities. And the fall in DC is a great place to be, so it's a fun tradition on campus.
That sounds fun. And Salve, Regina.
Yeah, I'll share a fun fact. So a number of surfing magazines have ranked Salve as a top 10 college for surfing. We are within a quarter mile walk of 2 to 3 beaches. We have 2 surf shops in town. So you can surf in the morning and go to class in the afternoon.
I had no idea. All right. University of Vermont.
Fantastic. I'm gonna follow Nick's idea with fun facts. The University of Vermont is located in Burlington, which was where Ben and Jerry's was founded. So if any of you like some good ice cream options, you'll have plenty of ice cream options at UVM. In fact, one of our UVM optional essays, you can address which Ben and Jerry's flavor best describes you. So there you go.
Is pretty
cool. I want to apply to school. I have to write that essay.
And Creighton University.
We are home. Our campus is home to the mainland's biggest luau. So I bet you wouldn't have thought that, right smack dab in the middle, just right smack dab in the middle of the country. And we get a lot of students from the state of Hawaii. We probably get between 65 and 85 a year. And for us, that's a lot. We're not a huge school, but so they fly out flowers and a chef, and all their family members come out, and we have a big old luau every year. So it's fun.
That is cool. And Sacred Heart University.
Yeah, one thing I would probably share is just one of the big traditions that we have on campus. It's in our spring semester every year. It's called Massapalooza, and it's a great opportunity, even though it is associated within the faith itself. It is something that is more community oriented. They have always performers coming up from New York City, or big food truck festivals, lots of games, activities, and just like moments of kind of like these come togetherness. So it's just a nice way to sort of reconnect with everyone before the end of the semester.
And University of Maryland.
Like I mentioned earlier, you know, the setting of your studies is definitely it's a unique environment. It's a leadership lab. I know the Catholic University is here, and I think that Washington, D.C. has a lot to offer for all of our students who are thinking about to the East Coast. One of my favorite time, I used to live in Washington, D.C. for a while, is during the Cherry Blossom Festival. All of our students take advantage of that, especially the Catholic University. I mean, they are in D.C. We are outside of D.C., so it does take about a little bit, 10 minutes drive. To get to DC, but I wish that we were a Catholic university where we are in the city itself. So all of our students take advantage of the cultural, there's a lot of history there. And so that's what we take pride on our environment. So.
Excellent. Well, I wanna thank all of our students and presenters for joining us this evening. Students, when you click out of the webinar, a couple of things. There's a quick 4-question survey. When you exit, if you could please fill that out for us, it would be really helpful for future programming. Also, there are more Marin County College Fair sessions coming up, so please make sure to sign up if you see other institutions you're interested in hearing from. And this recording will be available shortly on that same website where you registered for that session or for this session. So thank you all for joining us this evening, and have a nice night. Bye, thank you.